methods of purifications of organic compounds. Methods of purification of organic compounds. So once a organic compound is prepared in a laboratory, or organic compound is synthesized from a natural source, after that, that compound is purified by different methods. So that compound is purified by following methods. In that first one, sublimation method, and second one is crystallization process, and next one is distillation process. And fourth one is chromatography method. So these are the methods are used for the purification of organic compounds. Okay, one is sublimation, crystallization, distillation, chromatography method. In that first one, sublimation method. Sublimation method. So this sublimation method is used for purification of organic compounds. So generally we know that sublimation means the generally organic compound is exist in a solid state. So this solid state is directly converted to vapor state without liquid state. That is called as sublimation method, means the solid organic compound is directly converted to vapor state without liquid state, is called a sublimation process. By using sublimation process, we can purify the organic compound. And second one is crystallization method. So in crystallization method, generally the organic compound is exists in solid state. Some are easily soluble at room temperature. Some are insoluble at room temperature, but those are soluble at a higher temperature. The such type of salts are called as sparingly soluble salts. Means the sparingly soluble salts are insoluble at room temperature, but there are soluble at a higher temperature. So in that case, the solid substances are soluble in water. After that, they are cooling, they are crystallized. So that those crystals are separated through a filter paper. In that filter paper, the filtrate containing some impurities and some small compound, that small compound is containing a purified nature, so easily separate out. So that is your crystallization process. Means in crystallization process, the solid is soluble in water. After that, they are filtered out. Okay. After that, third one is distillation process. Okay. Distillation process or distillation method. Distillation method means the solid organic compound is heated under drastic condition, so the solid state of the substance is converted to liquid state, and further it is converted to vapor state. So through the vapor state, those impurities are removed. So according to their boiling point and melting point, some of the two liquid, if you consider two liquids, are having same melting point and boiling point. In that case, that separation is very difficult. In that case, we use ordinary distillation method. By using of ordinary distillation method, we cannot separate two liquids which are having same boiling points. The difference between the boiling point is very less or is not much. So in that case, we do not use ordinary distillation process. At that case, okay, At that case, we use fractional distillation process. Fractional distillation process. So, this process is useful for the separation of or the purification of organic compounds. And last one is, fourth one, chromatographic. Method.
Our next topic is D and F block elements.
Chromatographic method. Chromatographic method is used for the purification of organic compounds. Generally here, the mixture containing more number of components, those components are separated by a technique is called as chromatographic technique. In chromatographic technique, chromo means color. Okay, based on the color, we can separate the given organic compounds. In that organic compounds, how many components are present. So based on the colors, we can identify those components. For example, in a column chromatography paper or paper chromatography, here on the thin layer chromatography, if you appears a three spots, so means three different colors. If it is appears as a three spots, it indicates three components are present in given mixture. So based on that, we can separate those organic compounds. So in that chromatographic technique, the momentum of particles on a phase is called as mobile phase. It's called as mobile phase. And next one. On the phase, the particle is constant position, so there is no momentum, so those are the stationary phase means the chromatographic technique is having two phases. One is mobile phase and stationary phase. Mobile phase is where always moving the particle on the phase. Stationary phase means your particle is constant position. So these chromatographic techniques are classified into two types. They are first one, adsorption chromatographic technique. Adsorption chromatography technique. And second one is partition chromatographic technique. Okay, adsorption chromatographic technique, and another one is partition chromatographic technique. So in that, this adsorption chromatographic technique, here generally we are thin layer chromatographic technique, TLC. So means in adsorption chromatographic technique, that chromatographic technique is depends on adsorption process. Okay, so generally this one, the best example is TLC, that is thin layer chromatographic.
3D, 4D, 5D.
Thin layer chromatography method. In thin layer chromatographic method, so how can you prepare this TLC method? How can you use? See, so in that process, we use three steps, step 1, step 2, step 3. In step 1, preparation of silica gel. So first step is preparation of silica gel, second one is development of plate, and third one is detection or calculation of RF value. So in that first one, preparation. Preparation of slurry. And second one is development of plate, means nothing but your TLC plate. And third one is calculation of RF values. And fourth one is detection. So these are the steps which are involved in thin layer chromatographic process. So in that first one, preparation of slurry. Thus, generally the preparation of slurry, we use three types of components. One is chloroform, so CHCl3, and methanol, CH3OH, and generally we use silica gel. So this silica gel is act as a solid substance. So three types. So chloroform and methanol. If this chloroform you consider as a 66 ml of chloroform and 33 ml of methanol is mixed in a beaker and weigh 35 grams of silica gel G. Okay, 35 grams of silica gel G is weighted and added, mixing together and continuously stirring, we are getting a slurry. Okay, so that is the preparation of slurry. Means the slurry is prepared from only chloroform. 66 ml of chloroform and 33 ml of methanol is mixed in a beaker and weighing of 35 grams of a silica gel G and added and stirring well and continuously stirring, we getting slurry. And next one, development of plate. If you considering as a slides, so two slides are dipped in a beaker which are containing a slurry and dipped and remove it, and 1 to 2 to 3 minutes that slurry is dry out. After that, those slides are separate out and used as a plate. That is your development of plate. After the development of plate, after the base of the line, so this is your plate. After the base of the line, you are considering one spot by using a capillary tube. So with help of capillary tube, that is dipped in a various solvents like petroleum ether or benzene or water or chloroform or benzene. So different solvents are dipped as a slide. After observed, the solvent is moving on the silica gel. That process is going on. After few minutes on the slide, some spots are appear. So those spots are calculated by using RF values. So RF means relative factor. So this relative factor is calculated means distance. Okay, the distance traveled or the distance moved by a substance from the baseline by distance moved or traveled by a solvent from the baseline. See here, RF, the distance moved or the traveled by a substance from the baseline is denoted with X. The distance moved or traveled by a solvent from the baseline, that is denoted with Y. So that is gives RF value, means the ratio between the distance moved by the substance from the baseline to distance moved by the solvent from the baseline is called as relative factor.